In my opinion, Google AI Mode will be the leader in AI searches one way or another because of the familiarity principle in user behavior.
In September 2025, Google processes 210 times more searches than ChatGPT. And we know that ChatGPT represents over 80% of all AI searches to date.
So people who are so used to searching with Google now have access to AI searches with a single click.
Whenever they search for something, they see an answer from Google AI Overview, and they want to dive even deeper into learning more about the topic. All they need to do is to click on the Dive Deeper in AI Mode button, and they can start chatting with Google's AI model and get clearer answers.
So the question is, how can your content or brand be referenced or talked about in Google AI Mode? Let's talk about it. Let's go. So most people say that to get mentioned on Google AI Mode is just a matter of doing regular SEO ranking on Google SERP, and your content or brand will naturally be included in the AI Mode. While that is somewhat true, it's only part of the picture because AI Mode doesn't just pull information from top ranking pages. It looks for entities, contacts, and trust signals across the web. In other words, your brand needs to be mentioned, linked, and discussed consistently across multiple platforms, not just written content and keyword optimization to become visible and credible enough for Google's AI to recognize and reference. Now, Google AI Mode runs on the same model called Gemini, and when you ask the AI a question, you're actually speaking to an AI model, which means Gemini, the AI model, already has a set of knowledge that it is trained on. Furthermore, it couples with analyzing existing ranked web content, so it is not a model that aggregates information it finds on web search. The AI Mode already has basic knowledge about your query and it verifies it with updated information on the web. So this is fundamental to understanding AI Mode and how to get it to recommend your products or services. So we need to talk about this.
When someone asks AI Mode a question, Google doesn't just run one search, it runs multiple searches. For example, we have searched what is the best WordPress SEO plugin on Google, and as we click on the button to go to AI Mode, you can see that it searches and visits multiple web pages. And as you go through the pages AI Mode has visited, you can see that they are pages that target different keywords. So the query found out on best WordPress SEO plugin are best SEO plugins for WordPress, best WordPress SEO plugins, which WordPress SEO plugin to choose, how to optimize your WordPress site title tag, SEO Press versus RankMath, and RankMath versus Yoast.
So that's what it means by query found out. What about this query?
What is the best WooCommerce plugin for local business? Let's go to the AI mode. And now we can see queries that the AI mode looks for are best WooCommerce plugins every store needs, best WooCommerce plugins, free WooCommerce extensions, recommended WooCommerce local pickup plugins, WooCommerce local pickup plugins, WordPress local SEO, WooCommerce SEO, free and premium WooCommerce file upload plugins, enterprise WooCommerce development, and so many different query fanouts.
So AI Mode will break down one query you ask into 3, 5, 10, and sometimes even 20 different background searches, pulling information from each one and then compiling all that into one single comprehensive answer. Now, that's just one way to figure out the query fanout, but that's just the surface. There is something called the hidden query fanout that you won't see in a usual AI mode. So we've got to use the deep research feature from Google Gemini.
So we are on Google Gemini and I've asked the same question. What is the best WordPress SEO plugin? And while it gives me a very detailed answer, we have got to scroll to the bottom to look at the thoughts. And check this out. It recognizes that this requires a comparative approach, weighing features, performance, and cost. Then it will first seek recent content, a reason to always update your content, authoritative comparison reviews to gather broad data, and it will find key differentiating factors, such as these. So it analyzes these websites. These are probably the same web pages you see on Google AI Mode, but this takes a step further. It looks to confirm the top contenders and also find relevant alternatives. It compares the pricing models of the plugins, which is why if you are a business, it is important to write about your pricing differentiators from your competitors. Then it looks specifically into pages that talks about technical and performance of each plugins. So if you are writing about RankMath, Yoast, or any of these plugins, you have got to provide analysis of features the Google AI mode cares about, which is schema or markup, as well as site speed benchmarks. This gives you an insight into what the Google AI mode is looking for. So you will find fan out queries like best schema plugins for WordPress, SEO Press versus RankMath, Yoast versus RankMath versus all-in-one SEO, WordPress speed performance tests, and others. And this is where brand positioning comes into play. When many authoritative websites say the same thing, Gemini or Google AI mode will perceive it as credible. Such as RankMath is frequently highlighted as excelling in both areas, often cited for having the best built-in schema module, and being the most lightweight option with the smallest performance impact, and this about other brands. We will talk about brand positioning in a while. And then Gemini has identified that the ease of migration is also a major hurdle for people. So it will conduct research on this for the top contenders. And so you will see that it visited RankMath and all-in-one SEO pages to find more information.
So through this, we can identify additional query fanout like best schema plugins for WordPress and keywords related to speed performance of SEO plugins. So as a business, you need to identify what the important features and solutions are that Google AI mode cares about. In other words, the differentiating factors that could lead any brand, be it your brand or your competitor's brand, to be the top recommended by Google AI mode. And you will create content and align your products based on those factors. And of course, getting mentioned on Google AI mode and brand positioning isn't just about the content you create, it is also about what others talk about your brand. This is one of the most important steps if you want your brand to show up in Google's AI mode. It is not about any one factor like building backlinks, writing content, guest posts, or whatever. It is about the brand in entirety. Your product needs to be good enough for people to recommend. People need to see value in your product, and it needs to have a strong community of people who recommend the product. If any business or brand cannot capture these three important things, no amount of backlinks, guest posts, outreach, or blog posts will matter.
And according to Ahrefs' data, branded web mentions have the strongest correlation with AI visibility. The more your brand appears alongside your main topic on authoritative websites, the more likely Google's AI is to recognize and recommend it.
So if your product is not good enough, you may have to spend a lot of money paying many different authoritative sites behind closed door deals to write about your brand. And the question is, how long do you think the money can flow? Is it sustainable? I think no. However, if your products or services are good enough, coupled with your outreach strategies, you may be able to build a sustainable brand that Google AI mode will recommend over and over. So if your brand is totally new, there are three phases your brand needs to go through. Phase one is foundation and positioning, which means defining exactly what you want your brand to be known for. Is it going to be a specific market position such as lowest cost, highest quality, best for beginners, a unique audience segment such as for non-technical entrepreneurs, for enterprise teams, a distinctive methodology or framework such as best for topical authority, entity SEO, etc., or should it be a specific problem you solve uniquely well? You need to know your brand positioning. Have a good website foundation, meaning there are a lot of helpful content about your product and how it can solve problems. This can help with branded searches in the long run, such as RankMath schema markup, RankMath voice search. You need content about how your brand solves problems. And then you also need a simple press kit that includes a short paragraph about your business, professional logo, a brief founder bio, downloadable assets, and consistent brand image before reaching out to others. Then phase two is about outreach to find authoritative sites that are not direct competitors, like industry publications, news outlets, niche websites, etc. Don't just ask to be mentioned. Offer something useful like unique insights, data, or expert commentary through case studies or guest posts. That is the push technique. You can implement the pull techniques as well. And this goes to phase three, which is about amplifying mentions like holding money competition where the best content will win a certain amount of money, that will create some consistent stir. So what we have mentioned up to now are written content techniques, but to rank on Google AI mode, you should expand your reach as well. Now, based on our in-house research, we found that 65% of the time, a YouTube video is being cited as one of the sources in AI overviews, but we can't say the same for AI mode because it is hard to gauge the follow-up questions. But we very well know that most of the time, an answer from the AI overview will lead to a chat in the AI mode.
And the thing is, the AI mode do not only reference websites and YouTube videos, but they also reference content from other platforms, if the query requires it to. such as we have asked, are there any Facebook groups that help with learning AI? And it has provided many sources from Facebook.
So internally, your brand should have an appearance on other platforms like YouTube, TikTok, Reels, podcasts, as well as public platforms like Medium, industry-specific forums, Reddit, Quora, and Wikipedia. Displaying your knowledge, experience, and expertise on these platforms will quickly help you build upon something called EEAT, which is a concept that Google focuses on a lot. But that's not nearly enough. If you're into content creation, especially with a corporate brand, you know that views and attention are getting lesser and lesser, and we have to be more creative going forward. So on top of your own efforts, you should spend some money on advertising and sponsorships. However, it is not just about getting your brand mentioned. It is about brand positioning. Like KFC is known for their finger-licking good fried chicken. Subway Eat Fresh, we know it is about a brand that sells healthier and customizable fast food. Domino's Pizza is associated with speed and satisfaction. It is basically what you want your brand to be known, as we have talked about earlier. So don't just spend money on just simple advertisements. You need to send a clear message through those ads and sponsorships. This is what brand positioning means. In the past, you only have like one or two avenues like TV ads or radio ads, and you need to spend a lot of money on them. But nowadays, it is so much different. There are many paid advertising avenues. You could spend money on ads on platforms like YouTube, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, etc. And there are alternative routes as well, such as sponsorships and partnerships between brands. You can appear on other people's podcasts or YouTube channel as a guest, sponsor other YouTube channels or video creators to talk about your brand. You can also have an affiliate program where content creators can recommend your products through whichever channel or medium they choose, and this gives your brand exposure in multiple platforms. So these are the most important things that will get your brand mentioned on Google AI Mode, on top of all the regular SEO optimizations we have shared in this video right here. Feel free to check it out and let us know if it is helpful to you. Anyway, our channel is all about helping you grow your brand traffic, and if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.